Please be seated.
Veuillez vous asseoir.
The court is
now back in session. Now I hand over the floor to the lead co-lawyers for the civil parties to put the question to the witness, and you have 15 minutes. You may now proceed. Thank you, Mr. President, for the opportunity to put the questions to the witness, and good morning to Mr. President, Your Honours. Everyone in and around the courtroom. Good morning, Mr. Witness. My name is Pek Ong. I am the national lead co-lawyer for the civil parties. I have a few questions to put to you for the next 15 minutes. I will continue from the questionings of the prosecution. When you were working at the Terpengtmo work site, you were working there, you were still a child. Can you tell the court, when you were working over there carrying earth, building the dams, were you happy working there? Were you happy with the work you were assigned?
Response.
When I was working there, I was happy.
Lorsque je travaillais
là-bas, j'étais heureux. No, rather, I was not happy. How could we be happy? Because we did not have enough food to eat, and then we were made to work very hard. Question. The speech, the quotation of the speech of Mr. Kyu Sampon read out to you by the prosecution. It says they were happy, they minding cattle, catching the birds, and building the dams, carry waters and earth, and they were happy. So from that, I would like to ask whether or not this quote from the speech was a reflection of the actual situation at the time. The President, witness, please hold on. The National Counsel for Mr. Kyu Sampon, you may proceed. Thank you, Mr. President. I would like to object to this questions for two reasons. One is it is leading, purely leading question. And second, this witness cannot speak for other children at the work site during the Democratic Cambodia period. Mr. President, that is not uncommon that we read the quote from a document and then we ask the witness to respond to that. I would like to ask this witness to respond or react to the speech quoted of Kyu Sampon, so I think that that is the usual ways of putting the questions to the witness. The President, Counsel, could you please put the question again to the witness? It is rather difficult for him to respond to the question. Remember the last question posed by the prosecutor, he could not respond to it very well. So please simplify your question. Counsel, I would like to only extract a short portion of the speech. I quote,
"Je souhaite citer une petite partie de ce discours."
Our children were very happy with all the tasks, such as building dams and digging canals. End quote. So from this quote, he indicated that children at that work site were happy with the work they were assigned to. So my question to you, could you tell the court whether or not the children were really happy at the time? That was a reflection of what Mr. Kyu Sampon said, the president. Witness, you are now instructed to respond to this question based on what you experienced and you observed at the time.
Observer.
Witness.
Témoin.
That was what he said, but actually I myself was not happy. How could we be happy because we could not go to school? How could we be happy carrying dirt, carrying fertilizer? How could we be happy if we could have been happy if we could go to school? But we were made to work very hard. We did not even have anything to wash our hair. How could we be happy in that condition? Question. Could you tell the court when you were working in the Bang Thmor work site in Battambang province, now in Bon Thi Minh Chay? Did you go to school or did they teach you any literacy or numeracy? Response. No, I did not go to school. I could have been literate if I were able to go to school. But at that time, we learn how to dig the canal, how to carry earth, how to collect the fertilizers. That was what we learned. Question. So at the time, did you want to go to school, or did you ever think of going to school at all?
Avez-vous jamais pensé aller à l'école?
Response. At that time, we did not even think of going to school because there was no school. We only saw children carrying cow dung, fertilizers and dirt. There was no school at all, so we could not even think of going to school. Question. Let me expand it a little bit further on your work unit. Was it a child unit? Was it called the children unit at that time? And how many members were there in your unit back then? Response. It was my estimation. There were many members. In my estimation, there could have been around 1,000 to 2,000 members. I did not know where they took the children from, but they recruited them or selected them from the villages, those who were big enough, they could carry dirt and fertilizers, they would select them. Question. So there were 1,000 or 2,000 children. Could you tell the court more specifically of their age range? What was the youngest age and the eldest one in your unit? Response. At the time, they recruited from 14 years of age and above. I don't know the eldest age, but at that time, I told them that I was 14 years old. They asked me how old I was, and I said that I was 14 years old, and then they told me that, well, if I was 14 years old, then I could, you know, separate from my parents, and I could go to work. Question. So you said there were around 1,000 or 2,000 children. Can you tell the court the eldest member in your unit, how old were they, the eldest one?
Avait le plus âgé dans votre unité?
Response. They recruited children from the age of 14 to 15, 17, 16, 17, 18.
15, 16, 17, 18.
And then there was another special children group or unit.
This
special unit would be tasked to carry dirt to the to build the dam. So at that time, they lined the children into queues, and then they would help each other to carry the earth. Question. You responded to the question by the prosecutor about biography. You said that there was no biography taken at that time. So you were telling the court about these things for only the group or the unit you were in at that time. In other words, the biography were not taken for only your group, but not for others working at the Trupangtmo work site.
La biographie n'avait pas été collectée pour votre groupe seulement, mais pas pour, ce n'était pas le cas pour les autres.
Response. No, they did not prepare any biography. They only asked me how old I was, and I told them that I was 14 years old. So they did not actually take or write down the biography. So they would ask one from one to another, and then they would put them into different units. And I did not know where the children were all from. I only knew myself that I was 14, and there were many people, and I could not know other people. We stayed together for some time, then we got to know some of them.
Ensemble quelques temps, c'est ainsi que nous avons pu connaître Question. Quelques personnes.
You also mentioned that there was a meeting attended by Tawal. So, to your recollection, did you attend the meeting regularly, for example, weekly or monthly with any other person other than Tawal?
Response.
There were other people, but I could not know who they were. I only heard Tawal. And I actually did not even pay attention to what they said, because I only attended that meeting.
Question.
Rather, let me put it this way. Were you ever called for a meeting in your unit, unit by unit? Were you ever called to attend such meeting? Response. No, for that meeting, I was never called, but generally, we held the meeting at our work site for about half an hour or so each time, so sometimes 1 hour before lunch or after lunch, we would have that meeting. During the break, they convened this unit meeting. Question. During this unit meeting, if you can recall, what was the meeting about and how often was it held?
Et à quelle fréquence était-elle organisée?
Response. It varied at the time, sometimes once every 2 days, and all they said was that we had to reiterate our conviction to the work,
and that was it in the meeting. Question. Voilà sur quoi portaient les réunions.
Thank you. Let me expand it a little further.
Question. Je vous remercie. Je vais aller un peu plus loin.
You were staying at the Trupangtmo work site. Could you tell the court about the sleeping condition over there, whether or not you were given mosquito net or the bed to sleep on, or the shelter at the time? Response. As for the sleeping place, of course there was a shelter, but there was no blanket, no mosquito net, but there was a shelter. They used the we could stay together for 300-400 people. There was a very long communal hall or shelter where we could sleep at night. But at that time, we could sleep for a short period of times. In other words, we would go to bed at around 8 and then we got up at 3 in the morning. Questions. So if you had such a short time to sleep at night, did you have enough energy the next morning to continue working? Response, of course not. Question. You also said that you carried earth and then you slept with your hoe and your earth carrying basket. Did that happen often with you? Response. Adverse everyday occurrence. I slept with my hoe every day, so long as I went to work. Question. So when you were sleeping with your hole nearby, so could you tell the court how many hours did you sleep per day? Response. It depended on the people who were carrying up the damned. If it took them rather long times, then we could have a longer time to take a nap as well. Question. I have only little time left. I go to another question. When you were working at the Pentmore Dam, did you only dig the earth or you sometimes were made to carry the dirt as well? Response. We were rotated. On one day, we would be made to dig the dirt, and the other days, we were made to carry the dirt. Question. You said that you saw people being killed and then they were buried on the bed of the dam. How far was it from the scene to the place where you were working? Response. I saw that occurrence when I was working on the days. It was about 50 meters away, 40 to 50 meters away. Question. Did you witness it, the killing? Did you witness the killing by yourself?
Avez-vous vu l'exécution de vos propres yeux?
Response. Yes, I saw it by my own eyes.
Réponse, oui,
I was shocked when I was carrying the dirt. Question.
Tandis que je transportais la terre.
Did the killer was the killer man or woman?
Question. Et le bourreau était-ce un homme ou une femme?
Response. Of the three people, was the chief was the female?
Sur les trois personnes, le chef
questions.
Était une
femme. Rather, let me put this question in this way. I would like to talk about the victims, the
moi,
one who was killed. Was the victim male or female?
Étaient des hommes ou des femmes?
Response. Male.
Réponse. Des hommes.
Question. This is my last question. You did not have
question,
enough food ration. In other words, you did not have sufficient food to eat, and sometimes you, your ration was reused. Did you have the opportunity to look for something else to supplement your daily ration? And if you could look for that supplementary food, what was it?
Si oui, qu'alliez-vous alors chercher?
Response. No, not at all.
Non,
we could not find any supplementary food. We only had access to what was given to us, the food ration, the daily ration they gave to us. And sometimes we had to pick the skin of the potato where they threw away, then
parfois
we could eat, but generally we were very frightened as well to do that. If we were found picking that and eating that, we would risk our life being killed. Mr. President, I do not have any further questions. I thank you very much for the opportunity to ask the questions to the witness. The President, thank you. I think next the judges of the bench might want to have a few more questions to ask to this witness. Judge Fens, you may proceed.
Yes, thank you, President. Witness, my first question is aimed to help me understand how you use numbers. My understanding is you can't read and write, but apparently you can count. Is this correct?
I could count only simple numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I could do that.
So how far up can you count? Till 10, till 100, till 500.
I could count to to a lot of numbers.
Je peux compter loin.
But anyway, I could count only up to 20, 30, something like that. But too many numbers, I cannot count.
30, mais je ne peux pas compter lorsque le chiffre est trop élevé.
And I guess then that you cannot calculate, meaning add numbers or multiply. Is that correct?
Vous ne pouvez pas faire de multiplication ni d'addition, est-ce exact?
Yes.
Réponse est exact.
Now, I noted that specifically in the high numbers,
question, j'ai remarqué que dès que les chiffres
you
sont
appear
élevés,
to use them perhaps rather randomly. Let me give you an example. When you were asked how many children or juveniles were at the work site, you gave at least three different numbers, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000. Now my question to you is, are these numbers based on some kind of calculation, or is this your way of saying very many?
Ou est-ce que c'est là votre façon à vous de dire nombreux?
That's what I saw so many people, scores of people. I could not count all of them.
Tous.
So I could only say that there were up
alors,
to thousands, tens of thousands of them. There were many people building the dam.
Now, Mike, understand, but my question was when it comes to young people, juveniles or children, you said at one point there were 1,000, at another point there were 2,000, and I think yesterday there were 3,000. So, did you actually, as I said, count them? Or is this your way of saying there were really many young people there?
de dire que les jeunes étaient vraiment nombreux là-bas.
It was my estimation because there were many people. I did not do the counting because there were scores of people. There were not only 10, 20 people, but very well I went, there were people. So there were so many people. So in my estimation, there were that many thousands.
I understand. I'm moving now to another subject. And I really want you to keep in mind, tell me if you don't remember something. Can you remind us how long you actually were at this work site?
Pendant combien de temps vous avez séjourné, vous êtes resté sur ce site?
At that time, it was a rather long period of time. So I cannot recall how many months or years it took, but I know that it lasted for a long period of time.
So it could even have been years. Did I understand you correctly?
Peut-être même plusieurs années. Ai-je bien compris?
Yes, and that was my estimation. It was rather long. I did not know exactly how many months or years, and I could not bear with it, so I had to escape.
I understand that. Let's get away from the numbers. Do you remember that you saw changes of season while you were there? One rainy season or two rainy seasons, three rainy seasons. If you don't tell me, it's just I'm trying to help you.
Si vous ne souvenez pas, alors dites-le-moi. J'essaie tout simplement ici de vous aider.
When they mobilized the children force to work over there, it was only at the during the dry season. But during the rainy seasons, we were made to carry the seedlings.
Do you remember how many dry seasons you were working there
at the dam? Au barrage?
For my unit, we were mobilized there for only one season.
Mon unité n'a été mobilisée là-bas que pendant une saison.
Okay. Now I'm changing the subject again. I'm now coming to the killings you described to, I believe, the prosecutor. You said there were killings at the work site,
qu'il y a eu des exécutions sur le site de travail,
and they were meant to deter
et que ces exécutions
other workers.
Avaient un but dissuasif à l'attention des autres travailleurs.
And then you said they happened every 10 days,
vous avez dit que ces exécutions avaient lieu une fois
but
tous les
you
jours,
only saw it twice.
Mais que vous n'y avez assisté qu'à deux reprises.
Now my question is,
ma question est la suivante.
If you only saw it twice,
si vous n'y avez assisté,
how do you know it happened every 10 days?
Que ces exécutions avaient lieu tous les 10 jours?
It was my estimation. And I saw
réponse.
The killing of one person when I was carrying the dirt, and then after a while, then I saw another killing. So it was my estimation, but what
donc,
I saw was two times. That's why
moi,
I estimated that they would kill this person every 5 or 10 days.
Ou 10 jours.
But I did not know what happened after I left.
Let me just clarify if I understood you.
Question.
The time period between the two killings you saw was 5 to 10 days, and that's why you thought this happens every 5 to 10 days? Is this what you are saying?
Tous les 5 à 10 jours. Est-ce là bien ce que vous êtes en train de me dire?
Yes, that is correct.
Réponse, oui, c'est exact.
And now my last set of questions. I'm changing the subject again.
Je vais à nouveau changer de
sujet. I'm now coming to
j'aborde à présent
the incidents you described yesterday, where people collapsed at the work site.
Des personnes se sont effondrées sur le site.
And there were attempts to resuscitate them, but they died.
L'on a tenté de les ranimer.
That's what you told the prosecutor yesterday.
C'est ce que vous avez dit hier.
Now what I would want to know is what happened to the bodies, if
moi,
you know.
Savoir ce qu'il est arrivé aux cadavres, si vous le savez.
I did not know where they took the body to.
Réponse.
People who died on site were never kept there. They were, their bodies were taken away, and I did not know whether they were taken and buried elsewhere or they were taken somewhere else.
Can you tell us how they were carried away? Were they put on a cart or did somebody? Did people carry them?
Charrettes ont été transportés par des gens?
The body was carried away.
Ils ont
by
emporté
two people.
Deux personnes emportées.
It's like on a stretch.
Comme s'il y avait une civière.
That's how the body was taken. Actually, the stretch was made from wooden pieces, and I did not know where the body was taken to.
Je ne sais pas.
At that time, I did not see any hammocks that could be used to carry the body.
Et je n'ai pas vu de hamac, par exemple, qui aurait pu servir à transporter.
And how did you actually know that these bodies on the stretchers were dead? Did somebody say, we are giving up now on resuscitation, the guy is dead, or did you just assume that?
Ou avez-vous simplement tenu pour acquis que la personne était morte?
The person who collapsed and later died was at a spot near where I carried the earth up to the embankment of the dam. After the resuscitation, the person did not survive. And of course, I could only have a glimpse at the person, and then I heard that the person died. We were not allowed to stand there to look at the person for 5 to 10 minutes. No, that was not the case.
I'm not blaming you, I'm just trying to clarify things.
Who
tried to resuscitate this person or these people?
Cette personne ou ces personnes.
It was the workers on site.
C'était les travailleurs sur le site.
Because over there, when a person collapsed, then we would not distinguish whether it's a member of a group or a member of the group next to us. We would go there and try to assist the person.
D'aider cette personne qui s'était.
However, after the person died, I didn't know how the report went through the chain of command. The people would come and pick up the body.
How many of those instances did you actually see? How often did you see that the person collapsed?
Combien de fois
and
avez-vous
died on the spot after co-workers had tried to resuscitate him or them.
Combien de fois? Réponse.
I saw it rather often,
c'était
but I did not count how many times that I saw it.
Le nombre de fois.
It happened almost every day.
C'était
sometime a
jours.
Person collapsed.
Il
sometime two workers collapsed on one day. But sometimes they could be resuscitated and did not die.
Now, I know there are a couple of difficulties with numbers. Let me try. I understand that people collapsed daily, but they didn't die daily. When I asked you how many of those incidents you have seen, you said many. Now, my question is, for instance, more than 10 or less than 10? Because I understand this is a range where you can count. Did you see more than 10 of those incidents where people died or less than 10?
Cela plus de 10 fois ou moins de 10 fois?
It is more than 10.
Réponse, plus que 10.
Because it happened almost every
c'était
day.
Presque tous les jours.
So worker collapsed, at least each worker collapsed each day, or sometimes
tous les jours,
there were two
tombait.
Or three workers
des fois,
collapsed
deux ou trois.
On the day.
Again, I'm interested in those who collapsed and died.
Question.
So the number of those who collapsed and died was
c'est ceux qui
more
sont
than
morts.
10, at
Donc,
least.
Vous dites que plus que
is that correct?
Sont morts. Est-ce bien le cas?
Yes, that is correct.
C'est exact.
Next question is intentionally vague, question. Given that you don't know numbers.
Assez vague,
many more than 10.
Car vous ne comprenez pas bien les chiffres. Beaucoup plus que 10?
Many more than 10 who collapsed and died.
Y a-t-il eu plus, beaucoup plus de 10 personnes qui se sont écroulées, qui sont mortes?
Please repeat your question.
I'm trying to figure out how many people you actually saw collapse and die. And I understand there is a difficulty with high numbers. So you told me clearly more than 10.
Vous m'avez dit, c'était plus que 10, vous en êtes certain.
Clearly more, you saw more than 10 people collapse and die at the work site.
Se sont écroulées et sont mortes sur le chantier.
Now my question is,
donc, j'aimerais savoir si c'est
did you see many more than 10 people collapse and die at the work site?
Réponse.
What else you want me to respond to you? I
que
said people collapse and die.
J'ai
and
dit que
I
des gens sont
responded
morts,
three
et
times
et
already
fois,
to you. I don't have
dis.
Anything else to add.
Je n'ai rien à ajouter.
Okay, thank you. I have no further questions.
Bon, je n'ai plus de questions.
President, thank you.
Merci.
And the chairman would like to hand the floor to the defense team. First, to the defense team for Nongji to put questions to this witness. You may proceed, counsel.
Vous avez la parole.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Good morning, Mr. Witness.
Bonjour.
I would like to ask you some questions. Let me start. By asking you some questions in relation to the very last topic, the collapsing of people.
une personne qui s'écroule.
You describe one example. In respect of which you said you saw, or you had a glimpse.
Donc vous dites que vous avez jeté un coup d'œil.
Who was the person that you said collapsed? Who was he? Was he a member of your unit?
Était-ce membre de votre unité?
Or was he a member of another unit?
Ou appartenait-il à un autre groupe?
The worker was in the same big unit, but in a separate, small unit.
Même grande unité, mais dans une,
and the worker
une
that I saw collapse was not a member of my group.
J'ai vu s'écrouler, ne faisait pas partie de mon groupe.
So is it then fair to say you didn't know him personally?
Donc, on pourrait dire que vous ne le connaissiez pas.
Of course, there were many workers in the big unit, and we did not know everyone's name. I only focused on working, and I only knew the person was in the same big unit, but I did not know his name. And that happened to other workers. Maybe today I saw the faces of those workers, and next day I saw different faces.
Un jour, je vois le visage de certains travailleurs et le lendemain.
If you didn't know
question.
The person that you said collapsed,
cette personne que vous dites avoir vu s'écrouler,
if you only saw a glimpse, or only had a glimpse of what happened, how did you know the person collapsed because of exhaustion?
Comment savez-vous que cette personne a perdu connaissance parce qu'elle était épuisée?
That was my personal conclusion. It's because of the overwork and due to sickness, people collapse while they were working.
Il y avait de la maladie, donc les gens perdaient connaissance au travail.
But is it correct you didn't actually speak to any of the medics? Or any of the people who
vous
carried this person away.
The
fact that he collapsed because of exhaustion is only your conclusion. Is that correct?
Vous qui présumez que cette personne est tombée parce qu'elle était épuisée.
There was no medic.
Il n'y avait pas de soignant.
Came to attend.
Personne n'est venu.
The person.
Traiter la personne.
As I said, during the regime, there was no medic there to provide
dit,
the treatment.
Régime, il n'y avait pas de soignant pour,
are you saying there weren't any medics
question.
Working
aucun soignant
at the Trapping Tma Dam worksite?
Sur le chantier du barrage de Trapping Tma? Réponse.
Yes.
Oui.
And if someone got sick in your unit,
question.
Lorsqu'un membre de votre for instance, in the morning, and he said to your unit chief, I am sick, I cannot work, what would happen?
Je ne peux pas travailler. Que se passait-il?
If we were sick, we did not have the authority to ask for permission from the big unit chief. We could only ask permission from our group chief. However, we had to go to work although we were sick, and at the end of the day, maybe an hour or two before our rest time, we were given some round pellets to take. And of course, there was no guarantee the pellets that we took actually treated us.
Did you or any members of your unit ever go to a hospital nearby when that person stayed sick?
Est allé à l'hôpital lorsque la maladie dure.
I never saw a hospital, and I did not see any worker being sent to the hospital. What I saw was that when people got sick, they informed the group chief, and for some reason the group chief delivered the pilots for the workers to take.
This collapsing of people that you described, is that something that was seen by many workers at the dam?
Est-ce que beaucoup de travailleurs sur le chantier en ont été témoins?
Almost everyone saw it, but of course I cannot tell you who saw it. We knew each other by faces only, and not the names. You could see a person was in rather good shape today, and maybe next day his body was swollen. Or the day after, another worker had their a body became so shrink, so skinny and bony. Everybody looked so terrible, and it's even hard to identify and recognize the person that you saw yesterday.
If you said so many people saw this as well, can you explain to me why only you in this courtroom ever saw somebody collapse and die while working at the Tapping Tamar Dam work site?
Comment se fait-il que vous êtes la seule personne à avoir dit dans ce prétoire?
Objection, Mr. President.
Que les gens se sont écroulés sur le chantier. Le procureur.
Counsel is asking this witness to explain the evidence of other witnesses without having any idea who the other witnesses are, what part of the dam they worked on. He's been very clear that what he saw was for the most part limited to people in his unit and nearby him. It's an unfair question to ask him to explain evidence that he didn't hear.
Well, Mr. President, we've all been in this courtroom hearing witnesses. Nobody testified to this fact. Maybe he has an explanation as to why this is the case. Maybe indeed his unit was at a particular place. Maybe the regime under which he was working was particularly harsh. There could be all kinds of reasons that this witness can give to us, which would explain this remarkable discrepancy.
Cette différence est si marquée entre son témoignage et celui des autres. Le président.
President, the observation and objection by the international deputy co-prosecutor is sustained.
Retient l'objection.
And if you wish to put such a question, please quote the statement extract from the previous witnesses. And I believe so far we haven't heard any testimony from witnesses who worked in the children group like the current one before us.
Dans une unité d'enfants comme ce témoin aujourd'hui.
So if your question is rather too broad, I don't believe this witness can provide you an answer, and it does not help in ascertaining the truth in this case at all.
Thank you, Mr. President. Although it's kind of hard to cite evidence which doesn't exist, however, I shall move on. Smaller detailed question, Mr. Witness. Did I just understand you correctly when you said that you didn't have any mosquito nets while sleeping at night?
In the regime, no, there were no mosquito nets. That's how I went through. So how can I tell you if there was any?
Well, let me then quote something you said to the investigators, Mr. President, E3/7755, Khmer ERN 00279113, English 00293003, and French 00338220. And that this is what you said. When I lived there, they made a long shelter for us to sleep in. We had mosquito nets and blankets, but we did not have pillows. End of quote. So, Mr. Witness, you seem to be saying to the investigators a few years ago that you did have mosquito nets. So which one is it? Did you have mosquito nets or you didn't have mosquito nets?
President, witness, please hold on. And Councillor Pic-on, you have the floor.
Maître Pic-on, vous avez la parole.
Pic-on.
La partie civile.
The Khmer version of the ERN, as stated by the Council Copper, did not have any mention of mosquito net. It talks about the long shelter with two levels, and he was given a sleeping mat, and the mat was taken every time he went. So in the Khmer version, there is no mentioning at all of a mosquito net.
I gave the wrong page. It was Khmer 00279114. Of course, I cannot read the Khmer, but in my English version it says, when I lived there, they made a long shelter for us to sleep in. We had mosquito nets and blankets, but we did not have pillows.
President, witness, please respond to the question.
Le témoin veuillez répondre à la question.
Witness, I cannot recall that.
Je ne m'en souviens pas.
Plutôt, took place a long
je ne
time
me souviens pas de cela. Ça s'est produit il y a très longtemps. Le président.
Councillor Pic-on, you have the floor. Pic-on. Thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
The page quoted by Councillor Copper,
que cite Maître Copper,
that is on the ERN mentioned by Councillor Copper, is not related to the Trappes-Montmore Dam.
Ça n'a rien à voir avec le barrage de Trappes.
Although the word mosquito net was mentioned,
on parle de moustiquaire,
but this is a separate event, not related to Trappes-Montmore Dam.
Sur le chantier du barrage de Trappes-Montmore.
Thank you.
Merci.
That could be, I don't know. But then let me rephrase my question. Mr. Witness, you said
Monsieur
that there were no mosquito nets at all during the regime.
You just said that.
But here you said that maybe at another site,
vous dites qu'ailleurs,
you had mosquito nets and blankets. Is that correct?
Est-ce exact?
President, witness, please respond to the Defense Council's question. Uh, I do not know how to respond to that question.
Je ne sais pas comment répondre à votre question.
I will move on then, Mr. Witness. Let me now ask you another question. This morning and yesterday you spoke about the person who was in charge of all the Trapping Tamar Dam work site, Taval. You were asked yesterday by the prosecution whether you knew if Taval remained in his position or whether he was replaced. And then you answered yesterday, I don't know where he went after 1979, but he was there until the end of the regime. Can you tell me how you knew, how you know rather, that he was, that Taval was there until the end of the regime?
Réponse.
I do not know what year, but I was relocated to work at Dekrahom and to dig a pond there.
Pour aller y creuser
and they mentioned that the pond was named Taval's Pond.
Et on m'a dit so que everybody ça referred l'étang to de Taval. Taval. Tout le monde parlait de Taval.
Although I myself never saw him
mais je ne
in
l'ai jamais
person.
Vu en personne.
And we always heard that the instructions for us or the assignments for us came from Taval.
On nous a dit plutôt que
l'ordre de Taval. And then when the Vietnamese came to attack while I was digging the pond,
attaquer alors que je
I
creusais l'étang, je me suis enfui.
And everybody went through his or her houses.
Chacun est rentré dans
and
sa maison.
That's my conclusion that Taval was in charge until that day, the day of the liberation, because every assignment, every work site was named after him.
Avait la responsabilité jusqu'à la fin du régime, car tous les sites de travail étaient nommés après.
In your recollection, while working at the dam, in your unit,
question.
Was Taval always the one who was in charge of the whole work site?
Alors que, d'après, est-ce que c'est Taval qui avait la responsabilité en tout temps?
As I said, I never saw Taval in person.
Comme je vous l'ai
however,
dit, je
every
jamais
time
vu
my my chief told us about the work
mais
assignment, he always mentioned Taval. That's the instructions came from Taval. That's when we had to build a dam or dig a canal.
Donc,
or that later on we had to dig a pond.
And
during a meeting, I was told that there would be a big meeting where Taval would attend for the inauguration of the pond digging project.
Et que Taval allait y participer.
Maybe a bit difficult question, but do
c'est
you remember
un peu pour vous,
at one point in time when you were working
vous
at the dam that the group chief didn't say anymore
du barrage,
the orders come from
si
Taval but from someone else?
A cessé de dire
or did
que
he always
les ordres venaient de Taval et
orders were coming from Taval?
Ou disait-il toujours que les ordres venaient de Taval?
During each meeting that I attended, I always heard Taval's name.
Il était dit
I heard people saying that Taval came to inaugurate a project
Taval
work site to build a dam or to dig a pond.
Un chantier.
And regarding the pond that I was assigned to dig was not completed when the regime fell, so I fled to my home while other workers fled to their respective villages. And during the big meeting, although there was an announcement that Taval was present, there were so many attendees and I could not recognize which one was Taval. And usually it the meeting took place in late afternoon, and there was also a performance by dancers. However, the theme of the dance was nothing more than digging the earth or carrying the earth.
C'était une danse autour du transport de la terre ou du creusement de la terre.
Again, maybe a difficult question, but I'm posing it anyway. We know in this courtroom that the building of the dam, Trappingtemps Dam, started in 1977, around February. And we also know that Taval wasn't working anymore at the dam as of June 77, a few months later. If I tell you this, would that help you in telling us which period you were working there?
Cela vous aide à nous donner la période pendant laquelle vous avez travaillé là-bas.
President, witness, please wait, and Councillor Pek Ong, you have the floor. Pek Ong. The question put by the Defense Counsel to the witness is improper. He mentioned that everybody here in this courtroom knew about the starting date of the building of the dam, which is not a proper assumption. Councillor Coppers referred to any particular document which mentions the starting date of the dam building project rather than to say that everybody in this courtroom knows the starting date of the dam project.
Well, the objection shows that I was wrong in assuming that everybody knows the date.
But
I think it's not in dispute that the dam building started in February 77. There are
Fibus reports.
There's other evidence that goes to show that the dam building started in February 77. So I think, in all fairness, I can say that. It's unfortunate that the civil party lawyer doesn't seem to know that. But I'm trying to assist the witness by phrasing my question in simple terms, but I think I'm allowed to say between February and June as two dates that we relatively know for sure are in existence.
J'ai droit de citer les dates de février 77 et juin 77 puisque ce sont des dates dont nous sommes au courant.
President. The chamber does not give the floor to a party to make a second objection to the response by the party who put a question to the witness. For that reason, the co-lawyer, please be seated.
Look, Medvedev just copied.
President.
Councillor Copper, please rephrase your question.
Maître Copper, veuillez reformuler votre question.
And your assumption that everybody in this courtroom knows that the starting date of the bidding project of the Benchmore dam is rather improper. And that is your personal conclusion.
C'est votre conclusion personnelle.
Because so far we have heard of different dates.
The
project of building the dam started. You can put a question to this witness about his personal knowledge as to when the dam work site commenced.
La construction du barrage a commencé, de ce qu'il sait.
Or when he himself was assigned to participate in the building of the dam.
De participer à l'édification du barrage.
Of course, you acknowledge that your question is difficult, and for that reason, it should be rephrased properly.
C'est pourquoi
and it is rather improper for you to imply that everybody in this courtroom knows about the starting date of the dam project.
Il est assez déplacé de votre part d'impliquer que tout le monde dans le prétoire connaît la date de début des.
Mr. Witness, do you know when you started working at the Tapping Tamar Dam's work site? Was that in
1977? Yes, for the date, the month, the year, or the day, I do not recall. I did not know when it was started. I do not recall. I can only recall that at that time I was made to carry
dirt.
And maybe my final short question to follow up. Do you know how many months or what period of time you worked at the dam for how long?
Pendant quelle période vous avez travaillé? Pendant combien de temps vous avez travaillé sur le barrage?
It lasted a rather long period of time, but I do not recall the exact time period. And at that time, you know, even if I worked for 1 month, it was like for 10 years because the working condition was very harsh at that time. And at that time, you know, the 3 years, 8 months, and 20 days period was like a lifetime for me already. Working condition was so harsh. The President, the time is now appropriate for lunch adjournment. The chamber shall adjourn now and resume at 1:30 this afternoon. Court officer, please assist the witness during the recess and have him back to this courtroom before 1:30 p.m. Security guards are now instructed to bring Mr. Kirsampong to the holding cell downstairs and have him back in this courtroom this afternoon before 1:30. The court is now adjourned.